sepsis affects everyone of every age, but it's most impacting the very premature and the very elderly. The presentation of sepsis in babies, children, and adults is different. Where my area of specialty is in newborn intensive care. Many of the babies that I take care of are sick, but predominantly because of developmental immaturity. The rate of mortality and the development of sepsis are equally high in our preterm babies. In a baby that's born more than 12 weeks early, 6 out of 10 of them will have sepsis. And about 30% of those babies will die. Of those that survive, almost all of them will have lifelong disability of some kind that's major. The important differentiation between infection and sepsis is life-threatening organ dysfunction. An infection is something that you might get, but it's sepsis that will take a life. Having an ear infection is not sepsis, but if that ear infection was untreated and progressed to an infection around the brain, meningitis, that could generate a sepsis response. The intensive care unit has resources to help a patient breathe, be they a 500 gram preterm infant or a 300 pound full-size adult. We use mechanical ventilators, machines that help you breathe. We have drugs that help your heart to squeeze better, to help your vessels, the blood vessels, stay tight so that your blood pressure is okay. And there's 24-hour-a-day constant monitoring from nursing and physicians and nurse practitioners that help us to see whether we're making the right headway.